It makes more sense in his case. Even if his beginning came on streets that offered hardly any more promise. The craft was a family business. A comfort with conflict was embedded in his blood.
You know, I stayed with my dad for a certain period, of time. Then eventually I moved with my mother to Jersey. It was seven people staying in a one-bedroom apartment, no heat. I mean, sometimes no lights. You know, my mother was, she was on crack at one particular time. And eventually, you know, I moved back to Grand Rapids, Michigan with my father. You know, I asked my mother, can she move back also? And she eventually moved back to Grand Rapids, Michigan. And I was happy when she moved back, but she was back on drugs. You know, I seen my dad sell my mother drugs. You know, just those are the things that I went through in life. But I'm sure, of course, for Floyd Mayweather, it's more than just nice automobiles, more than just mansions, more than just millions of dollars. It's about giving back. You know, I love to, of course, give back to the less fortunate, give back to a lot of public schools, because that's where I come from, a hard, rough life.
It's the birthplace and hometown of superstar boxer Floyd Mayweather Jr.
Where you at, little Floyd?
Right here.
Okay, there you are with the crisscross. What color? Red, green, yellow, black. What happened to the shoes, Floyd?
With his father in prison and boxing his outlet, Floyd dedicated himself to the sport that was becoming his destiny. But there was also a dark side to Floyd's childhood. With a drug-addicted mother and a father who always seemed to find trouble, the Mayweather household was a dangerous place. When Floyd Jr. was only one, the elder Mayweather was shot in the leg during a family dispute, holding Floyd in his arms when the bullets flew.
I seen a little bit of everything. Seen shootouts, been in the middle of shootouts. When my dad was hustling, doing his thing, I seen my dad sell my mother drugs. And things happen, you know, that was my life then.
Years later, when Floyd was 16 years old, the older Mayweather found trouble again when he was arrested for selling drugs.
It was a bad, hard thing for me. I ended up going to prison. I did 3.5 years. I thought about my son a whole lot. I took the bitter with the sweet, man. I mean, you know, my son was doing good.
My dad was locked up. My dad was locked up in the feds. I had to become a man at a young age, at 16. At 16, I had to provide for myself. I had to make a way for myself. I came up past my knees. I was carrying a heavy bag on my back just to get to the gym, just to make things happen.
Decision.
Floyd took it like a champ, but not USA Boxing. They need to get rid of the whole system and get a new establishment to control amateur boxing.
I think that, you know, I don't really want to say I won a bronze medal. I think it's best to say I received a bronze medal, because you can't win a bronze if you lost.
Anybody with one eye 90 years old can tell me that Floyd Mayweather didn't score at least 40 blows in those three rounds. Floyd Mayweather won that bout. He won every round. And I said, with all due respect, I will not be involved in an organization that cheats young men out of their right to have a gold medal. And there's my resignation.
We all know I got ripped up, you know. I got to live with it, you know. I'm just going to, you know, take my bronze medal, you know, and go home, you know. You know, it's time for me to turn professional, you know? I can't deal with this amateur boxing anymore.
Floyd Mayweather was born into a boxing family. influenced by two dynamic figures. His father, Floyd Sr., a successful professional, and his uncle, Roger, a former welterweight champion.
Floyd was raised in the gyms of Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Try to get...
A youth spent studying those who came before him. His father and his uncle Roger, both well-regarded pros. Still, it was clear early on his talents surpassed even his pedigree. In 1993, under his father's tutelage, Floyd won his first National Golden Gloves Championship. He was 16.
It felt good, but it was very hard. I had to struggle, you know, struggle and fight. But first, I want to thank the good man upstairs for giving me this opportunity to win the national championship. And second of all, I want to thank my father.
Get rides to the gym any way I can, if I had to take a bus. Sometimes the snow came up past my knees. I was carrying a heavy bag on my back just to get to the gym, just to make things happen.
He would jog for miles. I mean, miles. His dad would just ride along. And I say that he would say, if I quit, then my dad's going to call me a punk. And I'm like, well, just tell him. He's like, no, I can't tell him. You tell him.
We start calling Big Floyd Joe Jackson because it was to the point where Floyd just ate, slept, and drank boxing. That's what his life was consumed of.
They go to the gym in the morning and they stay tonight. So it was hard on him. He didn't ever get to play that much. Like other kids did, he didn't.
Because a person is a Christian, a person is a Catholic, a person is a Muslim, a person is a Jew, I feel under God's eyes, we all are one. So I find myself praying all day, all day. I pray every day and all day. Don't nobody know it. That's one of my secrets. And I told you.
Everything you taught me from day one. I always remember.
Everything working, baby. Everything working. Oh, good.
Right, guys. Thank you,
hey, Floyd, be
like
careful.
You. I got you.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right, baby. Be good. Make sure everything's good. My man. All right. Yes, sir.
As we said before, this is a very pro Pacquiao house. And Mayweather is celebrating and working the audience. And some people didn't like it.
Floyd Mayweather Jr. knows he's special. He's the best pound-for-pound boxer in the sport. Undefeated, 43-0. He walks through life with a wink and a smile. A cross-cultural icon who dominates and agitates with an almost unnatural air of self-confidence.
I heard you went right behind my back and then you took some cash. I knew once you saw me out here popping, you would come confess. Don't tell me that you're sorry, there's no second chances, no, no. I put trust in all of my friends just like their family, and I know that I'm so blessed in this position. My hard work's making a difference. Believe in me, if you're with it, you suckers can keep on wishing. I put my life on the line, you kept your neck out the way. I had no fear in my mind, you were hiding out where it's safe. Now we're apart, I can leave and do this my own way. So get the fuck out my life, you're just a
D-lay. Up early, I'ma never be late. Writing what I want, like y'all better relay. Then we celebrating life till we barely see straight. They tryna hold me back, but I'll never delay. Nah, I never delay. Go 100 past, never had the chance. Wanna sign me 100 mil, I want that advanced. Got the party going down like an avalanche. Haters disappearing, you can call me Mr. Magic Man. Ever since I had this plan, I've been on a roll. Seeing every class, but with music on a roll. Y'all been on it kinda slow, trying to speed up what you know. And I'm heating up the game till they melt like popsicles. Waking y'all up early, I'ma never be late. Writing what I want, like y'all better relay. Then we celebrating life till we better see straight. They tryna hold me back, but I'll never delay. Nah, I never delay, nah, I never delay. Play that type of music, make them wanna replay. Nah, I never delay, nah, I never delay. Try and keep it real while the world be fake, yeah.
Yeah.
just chillin', kicking it, kissed by the sun. Could be soaked to the skin in the mall soon. I know she got the good vibes when seasons change, but we're the same. Even if I lost all my money, the zero runs deep, honey. And I don't need to speak a single word, 'cause you got me haunting, haunting. Even if my jokes aren't funny, my tongue tied up on it. And I don't need to speak a single word, 'cause you got me haunting, haunting. 'Cause you got me haunting, haunting.
Bye.